Okay, as we all know, this right here is the Pythagorean theorem. A squared plus b squared is equal to c squared, where a, b, c are just the sides of a right triangle, and c is the longest side, namely the hypotenuse. And that's pretty cute. However, we are all adults now, so let's do something more challenging. And to make it more challenging, one easy way is say, okay, I want a, b, c to be whole numbers only. Can we still make that happen? Yes, because I know you guys noticed I gave you guys two examples right here already. The first one is 3 squared plus 4 squared is equal to 5 squared. And the second one is 5 squared plus 12 squared is equal to 13 squared. Whenever these kind of things happen, we say that 3, 4, 5 is an example of what we call the Pythagorean triple. Because 3, 4, 5, they are all whole numbers and they satisfy the Pythagorean theorem. Likewise, 5, 12, 13, it's also an example of a Pythagorean triple. And the truth is, we have infinitely many of these Pythagorean triples, but the question is, how can we find them though? Keep in mind, this equation has three unknowns, so it's not easy to just guess and check and make it work. You can try and leave a comment down below to see how easy you think that will be, but I'll give you guys a better strategy. Wouldn't it be nice if we can have a generator to help us generate A, B, and C, and they are all whole numbers, and they satisfy this for us? That would be so nice, isn't it? So I will show you guys how to do that in this video. So let's focus on this right here first. On the left-hand side, this is the sum of two squares. It's actually not easy for us to work with, because I cannot factor that without using complex numbers. But it's okay, because I can actually move one of this to the right-hand side, and I will be working with the difference of two squares instead. So let's make that happen. Let me move this to the right-hand side. So I will have a squared equals to c squared minus b squared. And now notice, I can factor this out nicely, right? And this is the same as a squared equals to c minus b times c plus b. That's pretty much it, and that's pretty cute. And now the question is, so what? Well, a squared is, you know, a times a, so it has two factors. The right-hand side also has two factors. Let's try to balance things out a little bit. What I mean by that is, I'm actually going to bring one of the a to the other side, and likewise, bring one of these factors to the other side. Balance things out, all right? And you can bring one of these however you want. But let me just say this to the other side. And I can do so by dividing both sides by c minus b. So let me divide that on both sides. And in the meantime, I'll divide the a so that this and that will be canceled. So divide a like this. Now, let's see. On the right-hand side, we have a over c minus b. And this is equal to, the right-hand side is c plus b over a. So that's pretty nice. But what can we do next? This right here, remember, a, b, and c, they are all whole numbers. So when you have a whole number divided by a whole number, this is going to be a rational number, right? Therefore, why don't we just make this to be a rational number? I am going to set this to be a rational number in the following form. And usually when people say, hey, this is a rational number, we say that's a over b. But we have a and b already, so let me pick something else. Let me say m over n. You can, of course, you can do whatever you want. And n and n, they are all whole numbers. And depends. If you are still talking about geometry because you are still referring A, B, C to be the sides of a right triangle, or if you are doing number theory, that A, B, C, maybe they can be negative as well. So up to you. So I would just say A, B, C can be integers in general, but depends on you. All right, now what? Notice I have this, it's equal to M over N. Likewise, this is equal to M over N. And you see, I come out with two new unknowns, M and N. Our goal right here is that I want to write A, B, and C. They are all in terms of N and N. Hopefully, later on, I can just assign some value to M and N, and then I can generate A, B, and C. That's the idea. So let's make that happen. And we can do so by first make this is equal to that first. So we will have a over c minus b. This is equal to m over n. And likewise, this is equal to that. C plus b over a, this is equal to m over n, of course. What's next though? Notice, this right here is actually preferred because we just have the a in the denominator. So why don't we make that happen for the top as well? And we can achieve that by just taking the reciprocals on both sides. Here we will have c minus b over a to be n over m. Just take the reciprocals, right? And now we'll be working with this and that. And the idea of having a on the denominator is better. It's because then we can split the fractions. So let's go ahead and continue right here. On the top, for the first equation here, we can just do c over a and then minus b over a. And this is equal to n over m. And secondly, we do the same. C over a plus b over a. This right here is equal to m over n. And notice, the beauty of this is that this and that are the same now. I can just add these two equations up together and I can cancel them out, right? So let's do that. We add c over a plus c over a. It's of course just two of them, so 2c over a. And this and that will be gone. So this is equal to, I'm going to add this up. And of course, I will just get the common denominator first. Let me multiply the n and n here and the m and m here. So when you add them up, on the top, I get n squared plus m squared and then over the same denominator, which is mn. And I want to make this slightly cleaner, so I can just divide both sides by 2, right? So c over a equals to, allow me to write the m squared first, m squared, right? And then plus n squared and then 2 right here, 2mn, just like that. So this is great. And now, let's do the same, but this time I want to get rid of this term. I can do so by multiplying the top by negative 1, like this. Or you can just look at this as this minus that, right, up to you. And let's see what we are going to get from here. So I'm just doing this minus that, so this and that cancel, and then this minus minus becomes plus, so I end up with 2b over a. This time, we are doing this minus that. So we will have m squared minus n squared, and then on the denominator is still mn, like this. And lastly, of course, let's divide the 2 on both sides, so we will actually have similar form to that. Finally, we have b over a equals to m squared over n squared over 2m. Like this. And now, here is the deal. Take a look. I have a and a in the denominators. And notice, both of them, they have the 2mn on the denominator. So there must be some kind of connection, huh? That's great. And here's the deal. When you have two fractions equal to each other, the easiest solution is you just take the top to be top, and then the bottom to be the bottom. And the reason I say that's the easiest solution, because that's not the only way. For example, when you have x over y, if this is equal to 1/2, the easiest way to do this is you just take x to be 1 and y to be 2. But that's not the only way, because you can say x is 3 and y is 6. That will still work, right? So that's what I'm saying. The easiest way to do this is just to take the top to be top, bottom to be bottom. Anyway, I'm just going to tell you guys that we can take the following. Let me write down a first. A is 2mn. And notice, this equation right here also agrees a should be 2mn, so we are on the right track. Next, we have b. I will take that to be that, which is m squared minus n squared. And lastly, right here, we have c, which is equal to m squared plus n squared. How wonderful is this? Because here are two things you should know. First of all, we did isolate the A, B, and C, and then they are all in terms of M and N. In another word, you can just assign some values to M and N, and then these formulas will help you to generate ABC Pythagorean triple. And then the second thing is that you can also verify this on your own. If you square this and then you add it with the square of that, you are going to get this square. This right here is guaranteed to be a Pythagorean triple, right? It's going to satisfy the Pythagorean theorem. As long as you pick M and N to be whole numbers, you will get a nice Pythagorean triple. And of course, it depends if you are still talking about triangles or not. Because if you're still talking about triangles, then A, B, C, they have to be positive. But if you're just looking at this as a number theory question, and you are allowing A and B and C to be negative, that's fine too, up to you. Anyway, before we go, let's do a quick example. I am just going to take, let me say M to be 3 and N to be 2, right? And you can do whatever you want, seriously, but yeah, this is what I want to do. Anyway, let's see what kind of Pythagorean triple that we are going to get. A, based on this, we get 2 times M, which is 2 times 3, and then times N, which is another 2 right here. 2 times 3 is 6, times 2 is 12. And next, take B to be M squared minus N squared, which is 3 squared minus 2 squared, and you work this out, that's 9 minus 4, which is 5. Lastly, C, you guys know it should be 13 because that's one of that. But anyway, I'll work this out for you guys. 3 squared plus 2 squared, this right here is equal to 13. Because I told you, this square plus that square is equal to this square, right? So this is the Pythagorean triple that I got based on the choice of M and N right here. And you guys can have fun with these formulas. Just pick some values for M and N that you like and work out the ABC values and leave a comment down below and let us know which of the Pythagorean triple that you produce. Anyway, this is it.